Now, while the iPhone haters like myself...
Me, I hate them!
...patiently wait for the Palm Pre Rim, the makers of the old BlackBerry aren't giving up on the smartphone just yet.
Mm-mm. So, like...
Rim is one of the few cell phone companies that keeps impressing us, and the BlackBerry Curve 8900 is no different. It's the thinnest and lightest BlackBerry yet, and that includes the trademark QWERTY keyboard, as well as a gorgeous 480 by 360 resolution screen. With Wi-Fi, a 3.2 megapixel camera, and an enhanced media player, the 8900 is the total package for $200 with a contract.
So, like Rim says, it's the thinnest and lightest BlackBerry available. It can be carried by a balloon, if you saw.
Yeah,
but does that mean it's the most portable and stylish?
In this case, yes, it does.
It is. Yeah.
It's portable, but what do you think of the style?
I love it. I love BlackBerries. Yeah. BlackBerries are the best.
You'll love this one. It half an inch thick, weighs about three... Oh, sorry. Hold on. Tracking, like RoboCop. Tracking. He's good. He is good. Give that man a raise. Thick, weighs about 3.8 ounces. This is one of the smallest phones we've seen. And the new paint job kind of gives it a more stylish look than most BlackBerries.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel as plasticky, which is nice. So overall, this is definitely one of the most impressive BlackBerries we have seen.
BlackBerry is fantastic, and this one just proves it. So even though it doesn't have a touchscreen, which actually could be a good thing considering no one really liked the Storm, the BlackBerry Storm touchscreen. So is it still as easy to use like most BlackBerries?
Definitely.
Yeah.
I mean, everything
it looks
is
the
done.
Same.
Yeah, well, you've got the standard trackball here, which Rim has down to an absolute science. The keyboard is good. The problem I had was that the keys are a little small and they're not all that widely spaced. And so what happens is that you feel like you're mistyping more than you actually are. So it's not terrible, but
the other thing, I don't think it's when I was using it, it's not so much that they were small for me, it's that they work so well and it click, you're like, oh wait, you're used to having to push in a little harder.
Yeah, I feel like I couldn't sense the definition between the keys. I'm like, am I really hitting a Q? Am I really hitting a W? It turns out I was hitting the key that I wanted, which is great, but it's gonna take some getting used to for me. But the screen itself is amazing. It's only 2.4 inches, but the resolution is better than the BlackBerry Bold, which already had a gorgeous screen.
Yeah.
So kudos on the screen, BlackBerry.
Okay, well, because of the BlackBerry Bold, we know that the new BlackBerry OS is quick.
Like a fox.
It is quick. But did it make all the features seamless?
Yeah, totally. I mean, it comes with an updated web browser, which is a much better browsing
experience. Look how nice this is.
Yeah,
it's
really good. Look at all that text. Scroll it. Yeah. this is much better than what BlackBerry users are normally used to. Wi-Fi with UMA support, which is unlicensed mobile access. This is a big deal. You don't have to actually use your minutes when you're calling over a Wi-Fi network. So it's sort of like voice over IP. It's going to cost you $10 a month for that, but if you've got Wi-Fi in your place, why not? You know, skimp on the minutes. Media player with YouTube, DivX, MPEG-4, a ton of other formats.
Look how nice that looks.
3.2 megapixel camera with a flash. It actually takes decent photos of all the D-bags
on the
set.
Look how cute Danny is.
And the only thing that's missing right now is an app store, and that supposedly is coming in March.
Coming in March.
So there you go.
Now, here's the thing: is that it doesn't have 3G, which at this point now, when everyone's phones are kind of breaking down on them and they freeze up, you're just happy to have such a great working phone. It's $200 for the contract.
Yeah.
Now, usually, I hate that. But I love the BlackBerry so much, so I gotta ask you, do you think it's worth it?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely worth it. You cannot beat BlackBerry's email support. Its OS is getting better. Once the App Store opens, BlackBerry is gonna be a serious contender against the iPhone and the Android, even on their game. So it's really good night.
I love BlackBerry.
Yeah, thank you, by the way, for letting me keep this one, BlackBerry.
No, wait,
really
you have the iPhone. I use the BlackBerry.
Why don't I have both?
Why?
I got a new fanny pack. I'll just fill it with all the gadgets that I like.
All right, well, here's the best part. What are we giving it?
4 out of 5.
Yeah.
4 out of 5. Now, listen, there are a few minor drawbacks. Like we said, we would have loved 3G, more onboard memory. Touchscreen would be sweet. But, hey, this is one of the best phones that we've reviewed in a long time. 4 out of 5 is a definite buy on this one.
I love it.
You can play with mine for a little while,
can I borrow it for a year?
No.
A year. I'll give it back.
Okay.
Okay, cool. That's it for today's Gadgetron. But if you have a gadget you would like us to review, log on to g4tv.com/review this.